Good morning, my lovely kids. How are you all doing? I hope you all are well and safe at home. So I'm back here with maths class, and our today topic that we are going to discuss will be properties of addition. That is based upon addition and subtraction, which is of chapter number 2. So let's begin. As you all are aware of these terms which are used in addition. For example, I have to add these two numbers, 235 and 341. So these two numbers are known as addend. They are known as addend. And the result that I am going to get after adding both of them is 576. That is known as sum. So these are the important terminologies that you need to remember for addition. Properties of addition. The first property is order property of addition. Second property is grouping property of addition. Third property is zero property of addition. Order property of addition, which is also known as commutative property. Taking an example, 182, 316. These are the two addends. The sum that we will get after adding these two addends, as you can see, these are the two addends. The sum that we got is 498. Now, interchanging the addends, 316 and 182, we are changing the places. Now, the sum that we will get will be 498 only. I have just replaced the positions of the addends. As you can see, the sum is same. So, you can see that 182 plus 316 will be equal to 316 plus 182. The sum that we will get will be same, that is 498 in both the cases, right? So even if the position of the addends change, okay, but still the sum will be same. Second property is grouping property of addition. Here are the example. If we have to add 40, 50 and 20. For example, if I add 40 and 50 first, these two numbers will be added. What will I get? I will get 90 as result. Now 90, in 90 we will add 20. 90 plus 20, the result will be 110. Okay, I have made a group and added. Now another example for this. If I add 40 plus 50 plus 20, but now I add 50 and 20 first. 50 and 20 first I will add, what will I get? 70. Now in 70 I will add 40. I added 70 plus 40, the result will be 110. So this grouping property means that now in grouping property, even if we change the group, for example, over here we added 40 and 50 and over here we added 50 and 20. Even if we change the group while adding, we get the same sum. Okay, we are getting the same sum. So grouping property is used when we are using, when we have to add 2, 3 or maybe more than 3 numbers, we create groups. And even if we change the group of the numbers, we get the same number. The third property name is zero property of addition, or it is also known as additive property of zero, which says that if we are adding any number and if we add 0 to it, we get the same number. For example, I have taken here 315. If I am adding 0 to it, I am getting the same answer. That is, I am getting 315 as a result. Okay, 0 plus 315 will be 315 in both the cases. If 0 is added to it, that means I get the same number. To the number which I am adding 0, I am getting that same number again. So this is the property which says zero property of addition, in which I am adding 0 and getting the same number. And please remember, it is also known as additive property of zero. I hope you all have understood the properties of addition. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.